My name is Yvette, and today I'm doing a Hispanic Heritage Month TBR. Hispanic Heritage Month falls from September 15th to October 15th, and though I am Mexican, I've never really done anything special for this month. That changes this September. My goal for this month is to read books only written or illustrated by Latinx authors. The exceptions to this rule will be books that I'm still working on from August and books that come off of a library hold. The library waits for no one, including my Latinx-only TBR. I have 6 books I'm planning on getting through this month, so let's get started. My first book is Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur. Though the writer of this comic is not Latinx, the artist is. Her name is Natacha Bustos, and she is a Spanish-born woman of Chilean and Brazilian descent. This comic is about a genius preteen girl who has the inhuman gene. This means that if she's exposed to a certain substance, she'll develop powers, and she does not want to develop powers. So in this first volume, she's trying to create a device to stop this transformation. I'm not exactly sure how the giant dinosaur gets involved, but along the way, they become BFFs. This comic looks like it's going to be adorable, and I'm here for it. The second book is The Regional Office is Under Attack by Manuel Gonzalez. This book is about a corporation that protects the world from evil and global annihilation with the help of its team of superpowered lady assassins. The premise of this book sounds amazing, and I have high hopes for this book. The second book is When the Moon Was Ours by Anna Marie McLemore, who is Mexican-American. This is a magical realism novel about two best friends, one of them who has roses growing out of her wrists, and there are people after these roses. I don't know much about this book beyond that, but I've seen that it has trans representation, which I'm excited about. Next is Set in Dark Things by Mexican author Silvia Moreno Garcia. This is an urban fantasy novel about rival vampire games in Mexico. I'm doing this TBR a little late, so I've actually already finished this book, and it's fantastic. I'll be posting a full review of this book later this week, but if you're like, nah, urban fantasy is not for me, vampires, not for me, to each their own, but I really think you would enjoy this book anyways. It's got an awesome plot and full fleshed out characters, action-packed and fast-paced, and it's all around a wonderful book. Next up is History Is All You Left Me by Adam Silvera, who is Puerto Rican. This book is about a boy named Griffin whose ex-boyfriend just died. Understandably, Griffin is having a hard time getting through this, and the only other person who can begin to understand what he's going through is the boy his ex-boyfriend was dating at the time of his death. I've heard nothing but good things about Adam Silvera, and I'm pretty sure this book is going to make me cry, but I'm ready for it. For my final read of the month, I am going to try to track down Wonder Woman comics written by George Perez. George Perez is a major, influential writer of Wonder Woman who totally relaunched the character to have closer ties to the Greek gods. In fact, the director of the Wonder Woman film, Patty Jenkins, credited George Perez as a major influence on the film. This is where I'd give a description about the book I'm planning to read, however I feel like the public has a working cultural knowledge of Wonder Woman. So wish me luck, I'm probably going to try to go to several secondhand bookstores to try to find individual issues of George Perez's run to add to my collection. Wonder Woman is one of my favorite comic book characters, and to have issues written by a Latinx author in my collection that are acclaimed to be fantastic would really be special to me. That's it for my Hispanic Heritage TBR. Hopefully I can get through all of these. If you have any recommendations for books written by Latinx authors, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.